Sage. Myself, Rashmi Dikshit. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain key exchange algorithm. So what is the concept behind this? So look at this particular pictorial representation of symmetric encryption. Traditionally, symmetric encryption suffered from one shortcoming. It was necessary for either sender or the recipient to create a key and then send to the other party. While the key was in transit, it could be stolen or copied by a third party who would be able to decrypt any ciphertext encrypted with the key. Now, this is the disadvantage for symmetric encryption. And here comes the Diffie-Hellman algorithm. So, Diffie-Hellman key exchange establishes a shared secret between two parties that can be used for secret communication for exchanging data over a public network. So, exchange of a secret key, that is a particular achievement of Diffie-Hellman key exchange. And analogy is explained with the help of color example instead of number example. So, two parties, Alice and Bob, they are publicly agree on a single color. Now, in this example, it is a yellow. And these both party also kept one secret color with them. So, Alice, gray, and Bob kept light blue. Then, they mix both and then they exchange with each other. And after exchanging, they got their, means that particular original color. Okay. Now, what is Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm? So, scheme proposed by Diffie and Hellman in 1976 along with the exposition of public key concept. And it is only used for key distribution. It is a practical method for public exchange of a secret key which is used in a number of commercial products. So, public key distribution scheme, it cannot be used to exchange an arbitrary message. It is used to establish a common key known only to two participants. Key value depends on the participant and their private and public key information. This algorithm is based on exponential in a finite field, modulo a prime or a polynomial, which is easy, and security relies on a difficulty of computing discrete logarithm. So, let us look at the algorithm step one by one. So, two parties, Alice and Bob, in step one, they both agree on a prime number and generator. Now, in this case, the P indicate the prime number and G indicate a generator, which is common at both sides. Now, step 2, Alice and Bob both generate their own private key, which is secret at their side. So, A and B are the private key of Alice and Bob respectively. Now, it is time to calculate the public key using private key. So, this particular capital A indicate the public key of Alice with the help of this particular formula G raised to A mod P. Same way, B calculate the public key B, G raised to B mod P. Now, they exchange their public key because public key is a public. So, step 4 exchange public key and in step 5, they calculate the secret key. So, K is equal to B raised to A mod P and at B side also K is equal to A raised to B mod P. So, both side calculate the secret key using other side public key and their own secret key. So, K is the same at both side and this way the exchange of secret key is happen at both side. So, K is equal to G raised to AB mod P and at Bob side also K is equal to G raised to AB mod P. This is the same representation. All users agree on a global parameters, prime number or a polynomial and primitive root mod q. Then they both generates their own secret key, and from secret key they calculate their public key. After that they exchange their public key, and it's time to calculate a session key at both side, and after calculation it is found that the session key or a secret key k is the same at both side. So without exchanging actual secret key is at both side. Only exchange of a public key, that is not a new, because public key is a public key, it is publicly known to everyone. Session key exchange is happen, and that is a characteristic of a Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm. Okay, now we will look at here. So K is used as a session key in a private encryption scheme between Alice and Bob. If Alice and Bob subsequently communicate, they will have the same key as before unless they choose a new public key. So look at this particular diagram. Whenever public key changes, by default that calculation changes and session key changes. Actually a session key expires after some time. That is an important characteristic of a session key. So attacker needs an X to means for finding out X, they must solve the discrete logarithm. So now take one example. So Bob and Alice know and have the following things. Means P is equal to 23 and G is equal to 11. So G is a generator and P is a prime number. So these things are known to Bob and Alice. Now Alice choose a secret random number A is equal to 6. There is a no restriction, random number may be even or random number may be odd. And same way Bob chooses a secret random number B is equal to 5. Now Alice compute public key A is equal to G raised to A mod P, that is 9, and Bob computes the public key using the formula G raised to B mod P, that is P. Means with their own private key they calculate the public key and then they exchange their public key. So Alice receives B's public key and Bob receives A's public key. Now it's time to calculate the secret key. So K is equal to B raised to A mod P, and formula at Bob's side K is equal to A raised to B mod P. So same key exists at both sides. Sorry. So the common secret key is 8. That is important. So with the help of only mathematical function, Bob and Alice both are able to find out what is a session key for that particular session. Okay. So all of you, please pause and try to think. What are the advantages and disadvantages of Diffie-Hellman key exchange? So let us look out the advantages. The sender and receiver have no prior knowledge of each other. Communication can take place through an insecure channel. Sharing of a secret key is secure. We will just look out this example so that you will get idea. Here what is common? P and G, both party agree, then they choose their own secret key. Okay, they are not known to anyone, and by using that secret key they calculate the public key, and as the name indicate, public key is publicly available to anyone who wants to communicate. So they exchange that public key. And by using that public key, both sides separately calculate the session key which is common. So that is important. That are the advantages. Sender and receiver have no prior knowledge of each other. Now what is disadvantage? It is slow. Yes. and more processing is required. It is slow. Why? First prime number generator, then secret key, then calculation of public key, then exchange of public key, and then calculation of secret key. So each step involves discrete logarithmic mathematical function. So it is slow and more processing is required. But Diffie-Hellman establishes an exchange of secret key, which is used for symmetric encryption, and that exchange takes place with the help of public encryption cryptography or crypto system. So how these things are related with each other, but each thing has advantage as well as disadvantage. So this is a reference. Thank you.